morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night from wherever you're watching from. This is ANOTO in China. And right about now, we are almost departing Changsha to Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. So if you've been following me, welcome on board. And this is how my journey is from China to Nairobi. It's been a long stretch of a day, four airports in one day. First, I begin at Kunming at the Changshui International Airport. Then I go to Guangzhou at the Guangzhou Baiyun International Airport. And right now I'm at Changsha Airport. The next stop will be at Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. So those are four airports in one day. So welcome on board, sit back, tighten your seatbelt, and journey with me as I take you through the skies from China to the motherland, Africa, to Kenya. Ladies and gentlemen, this is ANOTO in China. And I'm here with Mr. Lee from China. Mr. Lee, ni hen hao ma? Mr. Lee is busy on the phone, and actually we are almost departing, as you can see. Oh man, it's been a crazy day. I've only had one meal from coming to this place. And right about now, food will be served. So let's see how it goes. Let me communicate with someone here real quick. So I show you what's happening. Right now in China is 11:46, the time in Nairobi is 7:46, so maybe in the next 10 to 11 hours we'll be in Nairobi. So we'll get to Nairobi maybe, worst case scenario, at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, or best case scenario, we'll get to Nairobi at 11 o'clock. I don't know how far it is from here, Kunming. No, here in Changsha to Nairobi, but let's see. It's my first time being here in Changsha, and this is Changsha Airport, and we are leaving to Nairobi. This is Team No Sleep for the last now almost 70 hours. I've not slept, but here I am, alive and kicking, so that I document this amazing episode, this amazing experience, so you don't miss out. And we're getting ready for the takeoff. This is Changsha Airport, and it's turning to the main runway, and the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we are about to depart, please make sure your seatbelts are securely fastened and the devices are in flight mode. No problem.
So flight mode. Maybe the waves might be too much. They might affect the frequency. That's why they say flight mode. Or maybe that's how the flight mode icon was invented. ANOTO, Zai, Jongo, ladies and gentlemen, this is big name, the man, the myth, the legend, ANOTO, in China. And right now, we are in the skies. The city is behind us. The future lies ahead of us. In a few hours, we'll be in the city of Nairobi, the city that never sleeps. We'll be in the motherland. We'll be in 254. We'll be in Kenya. From Kenya to the world, this is ANOTO in China. ANOTO in China. ANOTO in China. So these have been a very, very extreme, in-depth episodes of my journey from Kunming City to Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. I've been to four airports by the time I'll be landing in JKIA. And let's see what JKIA has to offer right now. The KRA and the customs say you need to clear and declare your luggage. And maybe you need to pay tax for goods worth more than 75,000 or 73,000, or basically $500. And I've got quite some luggage on me, some expensive luggage on me. Maybe it surpasses the limits they require, maybe 4, 5, 6, 7 times, something like that. Because in China you buy something at a cheaper price, but in Kenya, because of the duty costs, importation costs, cost of fuel, value added tax, you end up buying a product for a lot of money. So that's why I chose it, so I used to buy some few household equipment for the use in my house, and also buy several phones for my family members back at home. So I have like 7, 8, or 9 phones. Let's see if it will pass at the customs. Let's see how it will be. Let's see if I'll be harassed by the customs. And actually, one thing, I will not record my experience with the Kenyan customs, because so many people have had very bad encounters, very bad experiences with recording around Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. So if I get the chance, I'll record inside the gate. But once I get out of the gate, I won't record at the customs, and then I will record outside. So you guys keep following. I'll update more, and I'll show you my journey or my experiences. So they say time to destination is 10 hours and 37 minutes. 10 hours and 37 minutes, and right now the time is 10:108, so 10 hours and 37 minutes. So if we will be arriving in 10 hours and 37 minutes, what does it mean? It means we will be in Nairobi at 11:45 or 11:36, something like that. They say the journey, they have approximated using this, that we're going to Nairobi, and this is in Chinese. Nairobi, this is Korea, this is in Japanese. English, you are flying to Nairobi, time to destination 10 hours 36 minutes. And I said I will show you this. One thing I like about the Boeing 787, the big machine, it gives you this screen, so you can enjoy several things. First of all, it has several languages. This is Korean, this is Japanese, this is Chinese, English, and French. So I choose English, and here you can select some movies to watch. It's a TV station, music, games to play. And if you are traveling with the kids, we have a segment for the kids. features, applications, and oh my goodness, the turbulence. The turbulence.
Ladies and gentlemen, our airport status is under blitz. Please not sit in and pass your seatbelt. Do not use the electrics. Thank you.
So the announcement says that we are experiencing some turbulence, so you need to fasten your seatbelt and stay tight on the negative pressure in the ear. But I have some bulgur, I'll eat it to ease. I'm experiencing negative pressure in the ear. I get that all the time. Last time I came to China, the negative pressure was so intense until I developed tinnitus. I feel like things moving in your ears. I want, once they have served, once we've eaten, I want to chew some bubblegum to relieve that pressure in the ear. Normally, if for the case of me, if you experience negative pressure because of turbulence and maybe the rise in altitude at a very fast speed, you need to carry on some bubblegum so that you chew in the process. So chewing helps you relieve the pressure in the ear, so you need to carry some chewing gums with you, so to minimize that, or as a remedy to that negative pressure. Or alternatively, if you don't have bubblegum, maybe you have water. They say you drink water and then hold your nose together and you have to swallow the water with your nostrils squeezed, so like this. So that way releases the pressure in the ear and it becomes comfortable, because the pressure in the ear can be very, very, very uncomfortable when you're traveling. And especially when you're traveling on a big machine, a big Airbus. So I was showing you about this amazing setup. This amazing setup, this amazing screen. I've shown you, you can play games, you can, if you have kids, you can do something for the kids. Other features, applications, about us, Sky Moves, Sky TV, music, games, kids, and all about that. But right about now, I wanted to show you some of the features. What do we have? If you click here, you can scroll by this. It's actually touchscreen. You can scroll like this, or actually you can scroll using this sign here. You can scroll using this sign. So I was interested in showing you, but there's some information here you can also see. Travel 70 miles, ground speed. We are traveling at a speed of 420 miles per hour. So far we've traveled 71 miles, as you can see. So far we've covered 71 miles. And by the time we get to our destination, we'll have covered 5,620 miles. So that's a very big stretch. China is very, very far, and here it gives you information of what's happening. Time to the destination, 10 hours, and 36 minutes. And also it gives you the altitude. The altitude is 25,124 feet. The ground speed is 422 miles per hour. And again, we have traveled 75 miles. And the destination we're going is 5,616 miles. Headwind, 0 miles per hour. Headwind. Right now we can see 78 minutes, miles. What else? We need to charge this. I need to charge something. As I said, I need to charge my power bank for this camera. To charge
charge.
Oh man, I've taken much time to dedicate my energy to shoot these amazing experiences for you guys to enjoy. I've shot almost 9 to 10 episodes about the whole traveling to China, and the whole traveling back to Nairobi and back. So I want to continue shooting episodes for you, so be sure to follow, subscribe, comment, share, and hit the notification button for more details. I mean, I'm talking too much and people around me are sleeping. Mr. Lee is sleeping ahead of me. Guys, most of the guys are sleeping. I'm serious. Happening, people are asleep, but for me, maybe until they serve the food, I eat so that I sleep at once. But actually, I've really missed my eating habits because right now 1:17 in the night, but my phone, this one is ahead, the real time is 1:03. So another feature of this screen, you can be able to track the flight, see perspectives. This one is developed by Voyager 3D, powered by ASU. The maps and map data in this application are provided in the surveys or descriptions. They have something like a disclaimer. So as I was telling you, one unique thing about the Boeing 787, especially this big Boeing 787, just this screen, and this screen shows you where you are, shows you where you are heading, shows you the miles you are traveling. Oh man, and this guy is just messing with fun. So maybe so tilt. So this guy just push his chair behind. So I have to tilt mine. So as I was saying, another advantage of this screen, you can follow progress. Watch this. Wait. You can follow progress. So this is, you can see how China is very hilly. Because several hills. This thing is messy. I want to explain you something. Anyway, let's see. Distance travel, 103 miles. Distance to Nairobi, 5,583 miles. And it's behaving, maybe it's from the line. And here is where we are. That's another view.
Junction.
on. You can see this light is on, but for the others it's off. So this thing has hung. It's not responding, so this one needs to stay this way for some time. So I have to create more content. Because this one has hung and I can't control. Maybe I can. Let me just be patient. create a negative pressure and then push in the ear and release. Now, this is a good remedy for the air pressure in the ear. For this also, you thought and release. Actually, it's working. 100% it's working. So it releases the air. This is like a sponge. It's a sponge. So it looks like this. So you hold it at this tip. You press it in for it to suck some air. And press in your ear. Once you have placed your ear, you release. So it sucks the air in your ear. It puffs up, so by that it releases the pressure in your ear. It's a good remedy. One more time. Release. Oh man. And this is a good one. And I have to do it. It's nice. What else do we have? Provided you with a small treatment, so maybe after the meal I will go to the laboratory and brush my teeth. Maybe when we arrive I will brush my teeth, then I'll be fresh. This one you have, this one you don't have to give them back, and use, maybe throw it away or use it for other purposes. So this one is a purpose. This one, I'll use this. Next time, I don't need to worry because I got covered. This, there's two, so let me keep them here. And what will this be? Final, let me see. Maybe something to wipe yourself. Oh, they also provide you with this. Whenever you're feeling sleepy, you wear it this way. Wear it this way.
Gambi.
think next time a politician wants to vie for any political seat, he needs to be brought here so that he serves the people first before serving the constituencies, before serving the nation. You must be equipped with these skills to serve your people, understand your people, and serve them in a diligent way. That was for them. I've completed this. This first one was knocked off by the turbulence. And I'm pressed right now. But I have to wait for people to eat, and then I go to the laboratory. There's a laboratory over here. I need to use the laboratory, the Washington Motivation Engine. Cruising nicely over here at the back of the plane. We have this food. Our food is ready. Our food is very, very ready. And you can see people are being served some drinks over there. And this is a mirror. Ladies and gentlemen, this is ANOTO in China. Welcome aboard. My journey from China to Kenya, Nairobi, four airports. In one day, journey with me, journey with me. Let's see how it goes. This one has some space, so this is walking here. And you can see what's happening around this place. And, this is it. Never been to such a place. And I think this one is occupied, the washroom. So my friend is using this other one. I'm so blessed. also in use, so I have to wait over here. And right now we don't have any turbulence, so I take this time to document. And actually they are coming back. And also here they are coming back. I need to use Wei Shan here. The toilet is called the Wei Shan. So what's happening? You can't see what's happening. So if you want to say, I want to use the washroom, say Wei Yao, Wei Shan Jian, Shanzai. I want to use the washroom right now. And that way, you will use the washroom. Some places I need to use the washroom, so, and the crew is over here. The crew is over here preparing for.
It's safe to stay here.
Ladies and gentlemen, so let me show you. I hope we don't develop any turbulence. So I'm inside the washroom of the plane. This is a brief place where you can observe yourself and maybe you know what to do. And also another view of that. And this one is for the grip. In case we have some turbulence and you are in the plane, you grab onto this. And actually here we have the main stool, the main port. So here is where you do your negotiations. You enter here, you negotiate. Once you're done negotiating, you go back once again. This is where you do your thing. Another place for you to do your thing. And the more side views, mirror to do your thing. This is the place where we negotiate. So after you have completed your negotiation process, you wash your hands here. Wash your hands here. And there could be some turbulence, so I hold myself. Yeah, okay. So let me take a piece before you check the D's. Right, see you. This is ANOTO in China. And this is my journey.